Hi, it's Joel. Just want to share some stuff that I got today. Earlier I posted my haul from K-Day, and for those people who might see this now or in the future who don't live in the United States, K-Day is Kmart, and it's a retail store, and about three times a year they hold a special collector's day for Hot Wheels collectors. So in any event, during the collector event they offer like four special paint colors that you can only get at the K-Days, and sometimes like first to market items that are eventually released in other stores, but Kmart will get them first. In addition to it, you also, if you buy 20 cars and you save your receipt and you mail it in, you get a promotional vehicle. And for this particular K-Day, the promotional vehicle happens to be this in this picture here. Okay, so it's the 55 Gasser. And I was happy with my K-Day. No treasure hunts, no regular treasure hunts, certainly no super treasure hunts, but I didn't care about that. I just wanted to be able to get in there, get some cars I liked, get the, break them open, and so I could go ahead and mail away for this car. Bought enough to buy three of these cars. Anyway, that's the 55 Chevy. Also tonight was my Hot Wheels club meeting for the local club, but in any case, these are some of the cars I've broken out of the package. This was, honestly, I don't remember if this is a K-Day car, but I still love it. 56 Chevy Bel Air. I had purchased a 9-pack just to get this one car, okay, and then I found two of them today, so I got lucky. I didn't have to open up the 9-pack for that car. Still like this car. Camaro Pro Stock Dragster. And I like this color of the Chevy 2. But some other things that I purchased during the course of the week. This was one of the mystery cars. I don't remember what number mystery car, but the ones that come in the baggies. So actually, I kind of like this. This is going to go in my Camaro collection. I had another mystery car right here. This was a mystery car. Okay, passing gasser. All right, and that's a casting I like. And I couldn't find the original new model for this when it came out last year because all the collectors scarfed them up. But in any case, at least I have one of the casting for the Gas Monkey Corvette. And then this is a Matchbox. Opened it up because I don't save the packaging for Matchbox. Okay, so I had previously shown most of the stuff. Oh, and I forgot this. This is a 53 Chevy. And if you hear any noise in the background, it's my dog walking around. Okay. So anyway, those are the ones I broke out of the package. I used at least part of their card backs for my stuff, with the exception of the two mystery cars. Can't use those. I purchased this at Toys R Us on Friday. Traffic was so bad, I had to get off the highway, and I stopped at Toys R Us. Okay, I don't know if I'll keep this. I might return it. I'm not sure. Same thing with this. But I'll see what I want to do with these. But I do like the 55 Gasser here, 55 Chevy. Okay, and it looks like it has an opening hood. This one, I might return. I'll have to see how I feel. Okay. Looks like we're going to keep having problems with this. Okay, sorry about that. Okay, anyway. Move these out of the way so they don't get damaged. I got a tight spot to work here. This. From my club meeting today. So let's see what we got. Traded somebody for this and this. This was a K-Day mail-in for the last K-Day, the last one of 2017. I didn't go to that one. As I said earlier, I'm not into the JDM craze, so I'm not overly thrilled with having either one of these. But I didn't have them, and I know what they're worth on the secondary market. So. Traded somebody for this, and just so you know, what I traded was for all the last three models. This one and the other two were two California Custom Ferraris from the California Custom series back in the early 90s, and also a California Custom 40s Woody and Super Cal Custom Vicky Ford, I think it was. Okay, so I got this 56 Chevy. This one I like. I didn't get to the one K-Day to get that one. So maybe this was the very last K-Day. And the other one was, and this might have been the one before. I don't remember. So I won the door prize, or won a door prize, and I got this. Okay, so this is pretty cool. And this is from 1996. I actually have a Hot Wheels set, a sealed set that has, it's called Dinosaur Jump, I think, and it has a model of this in there. So, two of the models in here I could do without, and the other three, they're kind of cool. I really don't have them, so having my collection is a good thing. So I have that, didn't spend any money. These are some of Hot Wheels Garage, 70 Malibu Wagon, Hot Wheels Delivery. I got two of the 29 Fords, two different colors. Okay, so they're pretty cool. The purple compassion casting. I don't remember if I have this, so got another one. Don't have a lot in the way of Oldsmobiles, okay, but this is a 67 Olds 442. So, it's not a casting you see a lot of, and it's metal body, metal base, and the real rubber tires on it. So, and these Oldsmobiles look good in red anyway. Uh, Here's a 34 Ford from the delivery series. Okay, so I thought that was kind of cool with the thrush mufflers. Okay. I know I have this loose somewhere because I'm the one who ripped it out of the package years ago, back in the mid-90s, to put it in my display case. So I rebought it to have a package model. Okay, highway hauler. All right. So it's a blue card. Another blue card, Purple Passion. Sure, I have this somewhere too, but bought another one. Purple Passion from the Pearl Driver series. 1994. Well, I don't know, thought I was seriously into it in 98. Maybe it was beforehand. Okay, so anyway, got that. Got some short cards. Nomad. 69 El Camino. And I said in one video there's a variation in this, both with the engine and the cover in the back. There's no cover on this one. I bought another one I think I'll be able to show you. Okay. I thought this was cool. They're changing this casting. They're adding a lot more plastic. This still has a fair amount of metal in it. It looks like just the base is plastic here. Okay. But anyway, I just thought it was kind of cool to have a hot rod fire truck. One thing that I bought today that I normally don't buy a lot of is Fords. So I got a 40 Ford Coupe. Okay. In English, that's pronounced coupe, not coupe. Maybe in France they do that, not quite sure, but it's actually coupe. Okay, that's how it's pronounced in English, American English at least. I don't know about over in the United Kingdom. All right, and this is a flat black with flames. Like I said, I probably have a lot of these, but I have them packed away and I say them and they're relatively, you know, a lot of these I spend $1 or $3. I think the most I spent on any car was $4 and change. From the Flamethrower series, the 57 T-Bird. Actually always liked this casting even as a kid because I have the 57 T-Bird, the original from my collection. And this is from 1995. Also got some, didn't forget the Dodge and Plymouth products. Hot Wheels Racing from 2012. Dodge Hemi Challenger. And regular Treasure Hunt from, what year is this? Anyway, it's a Dodge Challenger funny car. Well, I can't see the year. Maybe 2008. But one reason I picked this up is because it's a metal body, metal base. Okay. Sorry about that. Here's what I want to show you, some of the changes to the casting. All right, this casting is from 2004, okay? It has a wing, no cover. This casting is from 2010. Took away the wing and it has a cover. And the engine still has that air snorkel right there over the rear deck. Okay. I had one at work on my desk that engine was in the back, didn't have any cover, no wing, and the engine didn't have this snorkel to grab air over the roof of the car. Okay, it had like velocity stacks, so that's a change for that casting. I generally like stuff with like regular black wheels, not, you know, oddball wheels and stuff like this, but I don't have it. I don't have a 4x4 Corvette in my collection, so I just went ahead and got this. And I think the color of the actual body is pretty cool, so. Sorry about this. We're going to have a lot of problems tonight with that. Let's see. See if it'll focus. All right, that one's 2010, so couldn't get it to focus, but it's a 2010. Another Corvette, and I probably pretty much have this one. That's a metal base, but it's a plastic body Corvette. Corvette stain, right? Pretty sure I probably have this top one and the bottom one. Fairly confident I have them, but anyway, 70 Malibu wagon, okay, two of them, so top one's from 2012, bottom one's from 2009, okay, no casting changes that I am aware of on these. '58 Ford Thunderbird. You don't see a lot of the Hot Wheels castings for these, so I picked it up. A couple more blue cards. Ford Stake Bay truck. And the Auburn 852. I know it's stuck behind there. When did these come out? These were 1992. Okay. What was that one? That was 1992. I'm gonna bet this one. So 27 years old already. Okay. Not blue cards, but I'm pretty sure I don't have this one. I don't know why I would have overlooked it. It is a Toyota Land Cruiser FJ40. I just thought it was pretty cool and I liked the colors on it. And then here is a Jeep Scrambler. Basically, it's just a Jeep with a pickup body, pickup bed. Okay, fairly confident I don't have this one. These were like the transition from the blue cards to different color cards, so they're, you know, whiter at the bottom, but no changes to this. I just picked up two of them because I like it. Okay. 57 Chevy. Both the same collector number. Another 57 Chevy. From 2011. When I see them, I pick them up. This 57 Chevy is different because it's a blue card. See, like the Chevy symbol right there, and it's got the like the line going through it. But these lines here, the color is the same. Plus, the blue card has the Hot Ones wheels, and these have the five-spoke basic. And this one's five-spoke basic. So just a couple different changes. Normally don't collect them because they look odd, but from the side they look okay. From the front and the top, they look long and slim, and it really looks silly looking, but the 59 Caddy. Okay, but I guess they did it this way, so they fit it on the blister card. Two different collector numbers, both blue cards. $1,991 for $266. Just saying a card. I don't know why they gave it two different collector numbers, because I had a paint color change, I guess. Don't know if I have this Chevy pickup. At least I don't think I have it in this color scheme, so I picked it up. It's also got some good weight to it. And I'll have to check the other castings they have, because I don't remember this much detail on the base. Even though it's plastic, I just don't remember that much detail, but this is pretty nice. It's got the blacked out PR5s. I think they're PR5s. From the Redline series, another Nomad. Like these, so I already know I have this because I collected this series when it came out, but picked up another one because I like it. And just came out last year. Pick one of these up because this really is a good color for this car, the red with the flames. Okay, and just four more to go through. From the 2008 All-Stars, the 62 Chevy. I showed the loose 53 Chevy. And I moved it out of my way on my desk, and now I can't find it to compare it. Here it is. It fell under you something. So here it is, 2007 new model. And here it is with a, just a recent release. Okay, for the Flame series with the Steelies. So you can see the change from the carded new model to how they're using it now. I just thought it'd be interesting to show. And they have the clear see-through hood. Okay. Alright, and the last two I got from, this was a Walmart series, I remember, but I didn't collect it when it was there. Probably should have. I have the 65 Corvette convertible. Last but not least, I have the 1970 Chevelle from the same series. I guess it's a music series because one is soul music and this one's disco music. So, I don't have this variation in the 70 Chevelle. Anyway, these were some of my most recent purchases and my club haul and trades today. So, hope you liked the video. Sorry about it jumping around. I kept knocking it off the stand. I'll try and work on that. Anyway, thanks a lot, and I hope you liked the video.